backpack on, like this, in the Seoul subway. Why do you think they're wearing it like this?
저희 채널을 즐겨보시는 분들 대부분이 펜실베니아 대학 사회학과 샘 리처드 교수에 대해서 잘 아실 겁니다. 미국인이지만 한국에 대한 지식과 통찰력을 자랑하는 그가 오늘 강의에서 아시아 문화권에 속하는 중국과 한국 학생들을 강단으로 나오도록 했습니다. 학생들을 본 샘 리처드 교수, 가장 먼저 이렇게 물었는데요. 한국과 중국처럼 아시아 문화권에서 온 학생들이 미국에서 가장 처음 느꼈던 다른 점이 무엇이었는지 말이죠. 그 후에는 한국과 중국의 엄청난 차이에 대해서도 짚어냈는데요. 과연 무엇이었을까요? 지금부터 교수님의 강의를 영상으로 만나보시죠.
Chinese classroom is quite different from American classroom because in China's like university, maybe like the rules and the structure are stressed more than anything else, so you don't like behave like out of your a certain kind of behaviors like in the classroom. You have to like sit and in a certain way that the teachers want you to do that. But like in American classroom, I think you can basically do many things that you want. So you can like go out to go to the bathroom, and you can like even sometimes like eat something secretly, but that's not possible in China.
Even like raise your hand and ask a question.
Yeah, you have to raise your hand in China before you answer the question. But like in like American classroom, you just shout out the answer and it's not a big deal. So
it's really following. Yeah. Yeah.
So I'm kind of feeling like more freedom in the US.
And here?
People and actually everything. Kind of like freedom.
Yeah, what do you mean freedom? Because when you say freedom here to Americans, this is good, right? They start thinking about you, that you're talking about political freedom and like, you know, freedom from the government and freedom from all the cameras that are watching you in China. But I don't think you're talking about that. You're talking about something else.
The freedom between, for example, maybe students and teachers.
Uh-huh.
For example, you and me, we can't. I think our conversation is more freedom than I did with my teachers in China.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Like we can have like kind of a back and forth.
I can say whatever I want.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
I see some people who are sitting like who sits like this in a classroom, but I never, and like none of my friends sit like this in my own country because I don't want the professor to think about me that I'm like rude.
Because if you do that, I'm gonna if I'm like right now. Uh-huh. So if you and I look, you were shaking your head, right? Like if we look out there and we see some people sitting like that, we're gonna notice them and they're gonna stand out like this, like right there, okay. Like he's gonna stand out, uh-huh. And like you don't want to stand out. Why don't you want to stand? Why don't you want to stand out? Like, what's wrong with standing out? Because we learned to be unique and stand out. Like, what's wrong with that?
I was gonna say like maybe when I'm with my family, like I'm not as like outgoing, like I don't make as many jokes or I don't talk as much. But then when I'm with my friends who are like American, I feel like I am louder.
So in what yeah.
What
is that?
I think the thought process is like you don't want to be like a nuisance to anyone else. Like when I go in public, I still do this. Like I try not to sit near people because I feel like I'm bothering them. But then when you think about it from like an American perspective, I feel like Americans don't actually like care.
You don't sit near people because like, you don't want to bother
them. Yeah, like
them.
I don't want to bother people. But then I feel like Americans don't think about that stuff. Like if you sit at the table next to them, they're going to be like, oh, okay.
Right,
but
it doesn't.
I think about that type of stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's like you're constantly measuring. It's almost like there's this radar going on, and you're measuring constantly all this like energy around you. And
yeah.
이 이야기를 들은 샘 리처드 교수는 자신이 한국을 방문했을 때 지하철 안에서 본 희한한 풍경에 대해 언급합니다. 바로 이렇게 말이죠.
They're backpacking like this in the Seoul subway. Why do you think they're wearing it like this? Yeah, so you don't knock. Everyone's got their backpack like this. It's like you don't want to knock anybody. Meanwhile, check this out. My backpack is like this because I'm not thinking about it because I didn't realize, you know, at first, like, because I always change it when I get in the subway. My backpack is like this. And I'm like knocking somebody like this and I'm knocking someone around. And then I'm realizing, oh man, hang on, got to change it around because you want to be small, right? And you Do you do this in China too? It's a thing. But it's such, it's like you want to be small. You don't, the last thing I want to do is knock into somebody. You know, like don't, I don't want to do that. I don't want to be in their space. I want to be really thoughtful and kind. And it's like, get out of the way. And people, when it's crowded, people are pushing around because you can't not do that. But it's like being really aware. I'm like, damn, man, that's this comportment thing, right? Like, don't just be really, always be cognizant of other people around so you don't make anybody else uncomfortable. Isn't reserved.
It's more about, because our culture is more on like respecting other people. So it's not about like being shy.
Yeah.
So like.
No, it's not. I'm glad you're saying that because it's not like a whole row of shy people. No, you go to Korea or you go to China, it's like people aren't shy, but there's, It's this interpersonal space in which there's just a deep respect.
I think like before Korea was modernized, we had Confucianism, which is like treat others with respect to elders and like having those culture. Like our country is really small, so in order to fight like bigger countries, like we have to be unified. So having that religion with like treating each other with respect, and now we're modernized and we don't have the national religion, yet like the Confucianism is still like
it's still there.
Yeah, so I think it's not about like don't stand out, be reserved. It's more about we respect you as much as we want to be respected.
Yeah.
번잡한 장소에서 다른 사람을 배려해 가방을 앞으로 매는 일. 사실 한국에서는 당연한 행동으로 인식되는 에티켓 중 하나인데요. 샘 리처드 교수는 서울에 가기 전까지는 단 한 번도 생각해 본 적이 없던 일이었다며 놀라움을 표한 것은 물론이고 한국에서만 볼 수 있는 독특한 배려 역시 덧붙입니다. 바로 지하철과 버스 안에 마련된 노약자석이었죠. 물론 다른 나라에도 노약자석은 엄연히 존재합니다. 하지만 샘 리처드 교수에 따르면 한국처럼 꽉 찬 지하철 안에서도 노약자석을 비워두는 경우는 거의 없다고 하는데요. 그는 이런 행동이 뭘 의미하는지 학생들에게 설명해 준 후에 인상적인 코멘트를 남깁니다. 이와 같은 행동은 한국에서 워낙 일반화돼 있기 때문에 일종의 의무로 인식되는 것도 사실이다. 그러나 맨 처음 이런 방식을 고안해낸 사람들에게는 박수를 보낼 수밖에 없다. 또한 이런 에티켓이 오랜 기간 지속되는 건 역시 타인을 배려하려는 한국인들의 마음에서 비롯된 것이라고 말이죠. 오늘 이야기도 흥미로우셨다면 좋아요와 구독 부탁드릴게요. 항상 함께해 주시는 구독자, 시청자 여러분 감사합니다.